This video demonstrates best practice for defining custom embroidery fonts. Digitize letters from backdrop images using any of the input method tools. Custom letters can be made up of multiple objects, which may be letters, numbers, symbols, or even pictures. Getting started. First, set up a grid to assist when digitizing. Guidelines also help to mark reference points. Set up grid spacing as shown. Vertical spacing 10 mm, horizontal spacing 0.5. Turn on Snap to Grid. Import the artwork. Click Import Graphic or select File, Import Graphic to import the backdrop. Use the grid to size the backdrop. Use E as a reference letter to determine the height of the font. Remember, we are creating a font for a nominal height of 20 mm. Digitize the letters. Zoom in to the horizontal stroke of A. Start digitizing using column A with satin stitch. Make sure you create sufficient underlap to bind letter strokes together. No underlay or pull compensation is required. This is added automatically when you use the custom font. Drag the zero point to the bottom left of the downstroke and place guidelines on four points as shown. Start digitizing. Make sure strokes are digitized in the sequence they will be stitched out. Generally, you don't need to worry about connections between strokes. This is automatically handled when packing the font. Save custom letters. Select all letter components and choose Object, Create Letter. Since this is the first letter to be saved, create and name a custom font as shown. Set default letter spacing, for example, 10%. Select the default join type, in this case, closest join. Now enter a name for the letter, in this case, A. Select the reference height, in this case, 20 mm. Now we need to digitize reference points. Toggle off stitches so you can see the outlines. Drag the zero point to the bottom left of A. Imagine there is a box around the letter marking its extremities. Reference points are where the box and the baseline meet. Place guidelines on either side of the letter where it intersects the baseline. Now draw the reference line. Add more letters to your custom font in the same way. Once you have finished packing it, test your custom font by creating embroidery lettering via Object Properties. Choose your custom font from the drop-down menu. Creating a multicolor font. The As Digitize Join method can be used to create special fonts with multiple colors or special effects. Here we use the Simple Offsets tool to create an outline for our custom letters. How much spacing should we give? While a 0 mm spacing offset looks fine on screen, we usually give it a slight negative offset, in this case, minus 0.2 mm, to adjust for the pull-push effect. Select all components of the custom letter and again save using the Object Create Letter command. Create a new font for your multicolor custom font. This time, use As Digitized as the default join type. Enter a letter name and reference height as before and untick the Remove Functions checkbox. We want to preserve the color changes. Now draw the reference line. Again, test your custom font via Object Properties. Choose your custom font from the menu. Notice that the lettering object preserves the as-digitized color changes within each letter. Use the break apart command to resequence like color objects in the color object list so that they stitch out together. Creating a script font. Now we're going to make a script font. Certain digitizing rules apply when creating script fonts to ensure that the tail of each letter joins seamlessly with the next. Digitize letters as you did the custom font. For script fonts, the tail of each letter has to coincide with the initial stroke of the next in order to create a seamless join. Place a guideline to mark the join line. Now place guidelines to intersect the join line where letter tails overlap. Use reshape to adjust the join edges. They should be approximately perpendicular to the slope. No need for overlap on narrow strokes, as pull compensation will provide sufficient overlap. Don't worry about connecting stitches between objects. Embroidery Studio automatically handles this when you save with the closest join method. Save and test your script font. To define reference points for italic fonts, draw a slope angle guideline and clone it to mark the letter extends, as shown. The guideline for the reference points always intersects the inside edges of the tail, as shown. As before, select a letter and apply the Create Letter command. Create and name your script font. Set default spacing to 0% and select Closest Join as the default join type. Enter the letter name and set reference height to 20 mm. As always, digitize reference points. Again, once you have finished packing the letters, test them by creating some sample lettering via object properties.